And all of this elaborate cognitive structure, because that's what it is, it's a cognitive structure, done with the purpose of explaining a complex metaphysical world which is not known, and at this stage it is impossible to prove it by experimentations or by scientific thought, and therefore it comes as a question that has to be addressed with what we have, which is pure logic on the basis of philosophical arguments. In philosophical arguments, what you end up with is not real proof, but probabilities or possibilities or explanations of logical magnitude that they are logically tight, which means they answer all the questions. How many times you have heard me saying that it's over 12 years now, I am asking myself questions. As a matter of fact, I was looking at my notes and I noticed that exactly the same things I said today, I have to prove it. I have them to prove it to you. I phrased them for the first time in 2000, in the year 2000, 12 years ago. I have the diagrams to prove it. Exactly the same things. And they were certain questions that they were actually straightened up, you know when? Now, today, when I was putting these things on. Today I had these final inspirations, specifically with regard to the dimensions. Very interesting. I was blessed to be given the answers at the right time. For many years I had these questions, but I could not answer them. Today they were answered. And I'll tell you something else which is very interesting as well. I spent 2-3 hours earlier in this afternoon doing the diagram, and I did the diagram and I still have questions. I can't find this piece of paper. Somebody has hidden it from me. Okay? So I came up here with certainty that I will give you the answer. And the answers came. I lost the paper that I walked upon. And I had to reconstruct. And when I came to the actual dimensions, a lot of things were cleared today. How? Don't ask me. Inspirations? Clearly. Who gave them to me? How would I know? But certainly it's not Stefan. The only thing you can say about Stefan is that he has done all of this work as an in-between, and he tries to find the answer. The answer comes. The answer is appearing mathematically. Even if I have to lose my paper. I don't know. I would like to find this paper and put it somewhere for the fun of it. But I can't find it at this point. Interesting questions. People will say coincidence. Yeah, coincidence. Yes, that's how it appears. But with a purpose in mind. And since we have the final result that I stand next to it, because what I put down now is going to the books. Okay? Then we can see clearly the purpose. I was forced to come to a certain point and ask help. And because I trust that I will get the help, I came up and here is the answer. And I will tell you once more. Is that the only way to do this kind of thing? No! I don't say it's the only way. All I'm saying is that this is a way that stands. That it is logically tight, and I can argue, and I can explain, and let the other people think, answer the questions and create more questions. That's the idea. That's the idea. We're talking about metaphysics. I don't know if I will be lucky to be alive during the period that people will try, will have enough instrumentation to be able to experiment on these things and prove them. I can certainly help into these experiments, into shaping up the parameters and so forth. I can certainly help. But it doesn't have to be me. I can only do, everybody's doing so much, so much, so much. And humanity at large is taking all of this hard work and extends its consciousness, which is the name of the game. Anyway, this is it. And it ends up on this side. Incidentally, the question you asked during our break about the microcosm, it's a very, very good one. And I would like to add a couple of words. It's true that the energy required to be able to sustain, create and sustain a whole universe is not paying, is not paid justice by the fact that I have in the first dimension the macrocosm. But I will remind you once more what I told you when I was answering. What you have here is the capacity of probably less frequency than higher there on the, where the group consciousness relies, but it is here that you have the capability of the high density necessary to create the universes. And this is why I have the macrocosm there. Whereas, as I mentioned already, up on the group consciousness, I definitely include the microcosm, which is the foundation of all the creation. It is in the microcosm where you have all the subatomic particles that everybody in the whole creation is using, and which are creating all the elements that are necessary in order to materialize.
And as you say, in service, without, just because.
Just because. They do that for their good heart.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They do have a lot of fun though. I mean, people will say that, oh, they gain something. Yes, they do. They feel happy, useful, and serene. Mm. And that puts them in a category beyond us. Again, not better, not worse, just different.
It is a big conversation, a big wonderful conversation. One of my tendencies along the way is to keep separating things out as I try to understand a concept or understand a parameter, let's
please,
say.
Please,
and so it
please.
Open. So it basically starts to feel like, it's hard to keep it all straight at points.
But that's okay. They will straighten up themselves.
Yeah.
We're doing now, you're collecting information and mm-hmm. you're getting ideas. What I recommend, is to keep on working on them because they are very elaborate. You didn't see yet the full picture. Mm-hmm. And the more you put them together, the more you will understand. Then the more questions you will create. And at a certain point you will not need me anymore, because then you will have enough information to be able to run on your own. Okay? Mm-hmm. And then you are going to help other people. All right, thank you very much. It was a wonderful opportunity. We tackled a very hard topic today, and I feel satisfied that we managed to complete it in an acceptable way. And because I have high standards, that means that it's not perfect, but does the job. So thank you very much. Looking forward for the last presentation, and we're talking about spiritual entities, and then we'll make sure that the whole thing, through the generous and kind facilities of YouTube, will become available to everybody, and I hope that people will take advantage of it. That will make my, not only my day, but my life. Thank you.